that time. Time for the video that will tide me over to December 17th.
Yeah, right. Grizzly Adams had a beard.
But it is about time for a moped video. I've done a video about motorcycles. Heck, I've even done a pizza delivery car. But now is the time. The time for...
pizza time.
We get it. The Spider-Man franchise from comic books, movies, video games, and merchandise is the most popular property in Marvel's collection. It's why there have been so many iterations and spin-offs. But no iteration had a greater impact than Sam Raimi's trilogy. I mean, can we talk about how many people had an appearance in a Sam Raimi Spider-Man movie in the early parts of their career and subsequently went on to bigger projects? Just that form of impact alone? Elizabeth Banks, Octavia Spencer, Emily Deschanel, Joel McHale, Daniel Day Kim, Bryce Dallas Howard, so many more. I mean, there's scientific evidence to suggest that it's the Spider-Man franchise that leads to fame.
You know, I'm something of a scientist myself.
But I'm getting sidetracked. Let's get back on course and align with our hero. With every hero who has a secret identity, we get the chance for the actor or actress to play two different personas on screen. This means we're not counting the likes of Iron Man, Black Widow, Aquaman, Cyborg, and many others, whose secret identity is their superhero identity. So, with Robert Pattinson, we'll get to see him play Bruce Wayne and Batman. And with every Spider-Man iteration, we get to see a unique take on both Peter Parker and Spider-Man. Many within the Marvel Comics fandom spend long hours locked in friendly and toxic debate over who is the better Spider-Man. I generally like Andrew Garfield's turn under the mask. I think his Spider-Man is more acrobatic and quippy, and just more so the alternate identity to a reserved high school genius. And I had imaginings that I would have been like that if I had let loose a bit more. It's why I had so much fun as a high school mascot. I also just can't jive with Tom Holland's Spider-Man because it pains me to consistently see a Spider-Man who keeps messing up. Spider-Man has been on the big screen for almost 20 years, and I think it's time the audience has a hero who just rocks, you know? Maybe I'm not explaining myself well. I just want my favorite characters to kick butt without the fear that their actions will lead to some misfortune. Tom Holland's Spider-Man just continually puts himself in danger. And with No Way Home, yep, while he'll potentially bring in all of our favorite Spider-People in one movie, he's causing the mess. Anyway, but when it comes to the argument of who the better Peter Parker is, I've seen many whittle their argument down to age. And of course, Tom Holland pulls off the high school age group better than the other two. But my favorite Peter was, and still is, Tobey. One of the many reasons I love Tobey's, and really Raimi's, Peter Parker is because Tobey just sort of acts more like a standard high school genius. And it's an inherent struggle when you insert web shooters, I get that. Andrew and Tom have the added need to be scientific geniuses because they need to develop their respective web shooters, and Tobey doesn't. Tobey's Parker is just someone who really enjoyed learning in high school, going above and beyond for many of his projects.
I read all your research on nanotechnology, really brilliant.
And you understood it?
Yes, I wrote a paper on it.
I knew kids like this in high school, and it was cool representation because it was more like something I could aspire toward.
Brilliant but lazy.
I feel like I nailed that characteristic dichotomy, though I'm trying to kick the lazy trait. Tom's and Andrew's takes are just unbelievably smart characters for the above-average high school and college student. Fun fact, did you know in Raimi's trilogy that Peter's getting his degree from Columbia University, the same university he acquired his powers from? The production studio is also Columbia Pictures, which is a fun
coincidence.
As Tobey talks about in an interview, if Peter was that smart and they had access to that technology, they'd have their own companies. They'd be millionaires. And there's even something more nuanced about that approach. Especially with Tom's Peter, who with everything he touches, it's either beyond the realm of believably genius or beyond the realm of incredibly stupid. Tobey's Parker is just more middle-of-the-road, intelligent, and studious. There's this misconception that a mechanical engineer can fix a car. Tobey just did more with his turn at the character to break that stereotype. Intelligence is something teachable. Since Tobey's Parker isn't a genius millionaire,
playboy philanthropist,
his stories, set in the middle of New York City, seem more real. Financial anxiety, living space struggles, transportation, food.
I had to beat an old lady with a stick to get these crammed.
All of these are just a more grounded, believable take on the boy genius's growth. Because of these struggles, he's taking the odd jobs of photographer for the Daily Bugle and delivery boy for Joe's Pizza. Within the hustle and bustle, the traffic, the irregular chaos of New York City, the bicycle and moped have proven, time and time again, to be the best way for carriers to get around. Whole documentaries and movies, studies even, have been developed to showcase the delivery person's efficiency. The research paper's development of the package delivery optimization algorithm is actually pretty cool, and if you're into that sciencey stuff, I'll link it below.
And you understood it.
Anyway, Joe's Pizza is a real place in New York City, with principal photography being shot at the primary location of 223 Bleecker Street on the corner of Carmine and Bleecker. Their lease for that corner location expired in 2005, but they were able to secure a location just a short walk down the street. In fact, three doors down. Regardless, though the 29-minute guarantee was a plot device, Joe's Pizza does maintain the delivery guarantee, keeping the signage sans 29-minute after filming wrapped. To meet those quality and delivery demands, they now have five shops throughout the New York City and Brooklyn area. There's even one in Ann Arbor, Michigan. So plotting out the New York locations, each store is within a 2-mile radius of each other, and then cross-checking with that study I referred to earlier, the best delivery within that location would be a bike trip all around. At the beginning of the movie, he needs to make the optimized 1.8-mile trip to the Woolworth Building.
42 blocks in 7.5 minutes. Your is fired.
On a standard bike with optimized route, that will take 12 minutes. Luckily, we're motorized. But unfortunately, we know how this story turns out. Let's make one thing clear, we're not going to fault the 1977 Pook Newport moped for Peter's tardiness. At almost 2 p.m., he's not in the middle of peak rush hour, and so if my estimates are correct, actually, disclaimer, I'm neither a delivery driver nor an NYC native, but if my estimates are correct, even with his delayed start time, he'd still be able to close the direct 1.5-mile line to the building within 7 minutes. He probably won't make it to the right floor in time, but we have no way of knowing which floor he's delivering to in order to make that judgment call. Let's break it down. The Pook Newport was really a base model Maxi S with different appearance package. This one still had the E50 transmission. We can tell from the circular gearbox. We also know because picture car coordinator Cyril O'Neill has made it known to the public the identification of the moped. And so even if we estimate the limited quarter horsepower 2-stroke engine spec, Peter still has the capable top end of 20 miles per hour. The E50 transmission means he'll be able to maintain higher speeds, whereas the ZA50 transmission will have more torque at the low end. In this situation, if we were to look at it blindly, he'd want the low end torque, but with how Peter's driving, he's not slowing or stopping hardly at all. So while he's driving at and maintaining those higher speeds, the E50 is his friend. At the straighter shot of 1.5 miles, Peter could get there without traffic in 4.5 minutes. If he has the less restricted higher horsepower of a whopping 2 horsepowers, with a top end toward 30 miles per hour, he could get to the Woolworth Building in 3 minutes. Either way, we have the flexibility of including brake and acceleration times to pad out those 7 minutes. I think he could have gotten to the building faster if he stayed on his bike as opposed to changing into his costume and swinging. Now, I know what you're thinking. If he didn't change, then he couldn't have saved those kids. And yes, you're right, but these videos are all about the vehicle and making sure they fit the needs of the character. So far, it does. Let's go further. From a maintenance standpoint, you couldn't ask for a better scooter.
I don't like that scooter thing you drive around.
Maybe moped is the more appropriate term. Made in Austria, the Pook brand has been described as the Volkswagen of mopeds, since they're easier to maintain and there are so few differences throughout their production run.
So you looked me up on Wikipedia, huh?
On top of that, the Pook Newport offers up to 120 miles per gallon of fuel efficiency, meaning less strain on the college student's wallet. The fuel tank only holds about 0.85 gallons, so a full tank could potentially give you just over 100 miles of range. Not bad. Cyril O'Neill managed to find 12 bikes in total among various states of repair. Among the collection of 12 bikes he had in parts, he was able to maintain 7 working models for the production run. 3 of them were used in the carjacking scene where Peter eventually says,
"You know, eat your green vegetables."
One last tidbit of info about the bike is that during driving scenes, audio is coming from an aftermarket exhaust. While parked, its exhaust is stock. Kind of a neat peek into movie magic. But a bike isn't complete without a helmet, and you know me, I did the research. The model he wears is very similar to, if not exactly the same as, a Bell Toptex Shorty half helmet, except not exactly, since those have the universal pre-snaps for either a cap or face shield or a number of other customizations. The one Toby and his stunt performer are wearing have been modified to just have the two snaps so that the Joe's Pizza sticker had better placement. These helmets were made through the Cold and Vietnam War era, many of them being produced in the 60s. So maybe these helmets belonged to either his father, mother, uncle, or aunt. It's kind of a cool mental image. However, a warning, since this is all purely academic.
This is all hypothetical, isn't it? All academic.
I wouldn't recommend going out to get one just to match the look. Spider-Man had both his Spidey sense and superhuman durability to help protect his noggin, and you don't.
My back! Oh, my back!
So when you're deciding about your head protection, go with something that is going to give you the most coverage. If you're really wanting the look but can handle trading exactness for better tested crash durability, then go with Bell's Scout Air Open Face. That helmet is passing the modern DOT certification during its quality control, so even if they're not the best helmet on the road, they'll provide better protection while giving you a similar look. And I think that covers it. The Pook mopeds are some of the most well-known yet most forgotten pieces of automotive history, and having a major blockbuster image was kind of nice for the moped community. But they're also still relatively cheap if you're looking at used vehicle online marketplaces. So you could mimic the college Peter Parker life for less than $1,000 if you were really hunting for a deal. Is this the right vehicle for Peter Parker? Oh yeah, 100% a yes. I think it was brilliant on the part of Cyril to have something so forgiving yet so perfect for his college and work needs. It's also just better when setting up the dramatic walk home from a failed attempt to attend MJ's play. Luckily, both his love life and moped life are renewed for the third movie. You may not think this moped a vested part of the franchise, but if that were true, would there be a 3D scan? It's actually pretty neat. I found it on sketchfab.com. I, like many other fans, are manifesting the reappearance of Toby Spider-Man alongside the likes of Andrew, Tom, and
Doctor Strange.
That's pretty good. But it's taken!
Coincidence?
I guess we'll just have to wait. Thanks for watching, drink some water, and I'll see you all in the next one.